So Derek, to start with, although the theme is social justice, but there are a lot of things that have dominated the political discourse and the media coverage in the last few days, and it's going to do that again, which is related to social justice. One of the things is that the 8th November is approaching, right, which is the anniversary of what you would like to call Black Day, what the BJP government would like to call Anti-Black Money Day. What is the progress? So you lately I heard that you, all the opposition parties are coming together, one platform, and going to launch a huge protest.
Imitation, they say, is the best form of flattery. We did a press conference a few days ago, the opposition, Ghulam Nabi Azad ji and I, and Sharad Yadav ji addressed the press conference, but that was just three of us. That was all 17, that was the voice. Can you all hear me at the back? That was the voice of 17, 18 political parties. Obviously, the coordination was done by the president of the Congress party, Sonia Gandhi. We, the Trinamool Congress, under Mamata Banerjee, have 47 MPs, so we have a large number of MPs. So we all came up with this idea, discussed it with the opposition parties, all of us, and we came up with this idea of Black Day. 48 hours later, the BJP have come up with something around that on the 8th of November. I was just telling the panelists here before, they were met me on the way out, I said, you know you've got something right. You know you've got under their skin. You know you're making a point. Because when you start copying the opposition's ideas, you know the BJP is in trouble.
So you really think the BJP is on the sticky ground?
No, I don't think they are on a sticky ground. Because the sticky ground means only the pitch in a cricket match is where the ball turns or doesn't turn. But not only the pitch, the entire ground now has become very, very difficult. But I don't think this is the time for big talk. The opposition have an important role to play, two roles to play. We need to focus on what we believe is the correct narrative. Where are the jobs? What is the state of the economy? What is the situation after demonetization? What a disaster after a hasty GST rollout. What about the farmer suicides? I think these are the issues, be it the Congress, the Trinamool, the RJD, the DMK, the SP, the BSP, and a whole lot of other parties, the AAP. We need to keep focusing on these subjects because the BJP don't have a story for the economy. They don't have a story for jobs. They don't have a story for why GST was hastily rolled out. They don't have a story for the scam of the century, the demonetization. So what do they try and do? They try and change the narrative. I'm not even going to talk about what they're going to change the narrative to. Because if I talk about that narrative, that's the narrative we shouldn't be speaking. So not only today outside parliament, but what you will see in parliament, which today is the 27th of October. We don't even know when parliament starts. If you ask the leader of the house who's from the BJP, if you ask him what are the dates for parliament, he'll not be able to tell you. You ask the chairman of the Rajya Sabha, who's the vice president of India, he won't be able to tell you.
But why
if you ask the union cabinet, they won't be able to tell you. So, Mr. M and Mr. S, when they decide over Dhokla, then we'll all get to know the date. Till then, we don't know. I've not done, I love Dhoklas, by the way.
But I've never seen Derek holding back, you know, in taking names of the individual that you're targeting.
Mr. M is Modi and Mr. S is Shah. I'm not going to give you 10 points for answering that quiz question.
Now, you talk about Gujarat. On a serious note, you know, demonetization is going to be a huge issue there. I've been to Gujarat. People are now mocking development. Development has gone crazy. This has also seen the reincarnation of Rahul Gandhi as a brand. Do you see, you know, that Rahul Gandhi has finally arrived, you know, as a leader?
See, I'm not here to pass comments about who has arrived and who hasn't arrived. But what I will tell you is that you start reacting to people when those people hassle you. So you don't need a Trinamool Congress parliamentary party leader to tell you, or a spokesperson of the Trinamool Congress to tell you, that the BJP is under pressure. Of course the BJP is under pressure. How this pressure reflects in elections in Gujarat, or how it reflects in Himachal, you know, win or lose Gujarat, or win or lose Himachal, the match is still on for 2019. Match on. You know, I believe the discourse, frankly, as a student of politics, even 6 months ago, the discourse was, okay, the BJP is far ahead. That is not the story. That is not the story. In fact, as I said, it's match on. And I'll make one more point here, Rifat. I think along with the opposition, there is another force in play. And that is within the BJP. I do believe that there is a lot of discomfort in the BJP itself. Because in this large country of ours, if decisions are taken by two individuals, it becomes a problem. So far, some MPs have spoken out. Some talk about it in Central Hall. But let's see, we still have some way to go to 2019 and match on.
So why do you think demonetization did not affect adversely the BJP's poll prospect in UP?
That's a good question. Because I think they marketed in the short term, you can market something very, very well. You know, the great advertising guru David Ogilvy said that, you know, you can sell. Did anyone quote Ogilvy earlier? No. Okay. Because David Ogilvy said it's very easy for somebody to get somebody to buy a product once. You buy it. The more difficult thing is to have a repurchase of that product. I traveled in UP for 1 week, end of November. So you know what the Trinamool view and Mamatadi's view was on demonetization. And I don't want to, say we went first and everyone else followed. You don't need to say that, because history records who said what when, you know. It was very, very clear in UP within 3 weeks that Modi ji had managed to sell a story where anybody who opposed demonetization was corrupt. This is the story. Anybody who opposed it was corrupt. But as it has turned out to be, in all what has happened, and it's a well-documented fact now, that hasn't happened. I don't even know whether it will happen in Gujarat. Because when you look at the Gujarat election, and sometimes we tend to look at too many elections through our tinted only political glasses, you are taking on the BJP in Gujarat, where they have their number one star campaigner. One. Number two, he's a Gujarati by birth. So in that sense, quote unquote, he's a Gujarati boy. So it's always nice to see from that point of view, your prime minister being from your state. And number three, I don't think there's a big opposition face which is there. So the dice would still be loaded Gujarat. But what is the starting point for Gujarat? Let's define the benchmark. The benchmark is the national president of the BJP has said, we are 118, we will get to 150. To me, that's the starting point.
Yeah. Okay. You know, this demonetization and the impact it may have on Gujarat, we will see. Coming back to the local politics here, another controversial decision of the BJP government has been of mandatory linkage of Aadhaar to various things, including your bank accounts and mobile.
I'm doing a Facebook live today at 6 o'clock, only on this Aadhaar. Yes.
Okay.
And so you heard what my chief minister said.
Correct.
And
I'm coming to that.
Yeah.
So is she really serious when she says, I will not link even if they deactivate my number?
When Mamata di says something, she's serious about it. Not only serious about it, she's more than serious about it. Why would she's not one to, you know, yeah.
So do you think Ms. Banerjee saying that would also prompt other people, you know, your hundreds and thousands of followers to do that?
You know what happened? As soon as that announcement was made, what did the government announce? They pushed the date back to the 31st of March. You know, I'll tell you what was done. That was on the 25th, which was a Wednesday. On the 23rd, the former Home Minister of the country, Mr. Chidambaram, and I, we are on a Home Affairs Committee, chaired by him. I'm a member. And guess what the subject was? I can't speak in detail because if I disclose what was discussed at a parliamentary standing committee, then I would be breach of privilege. But I can tell you, the subject matter was privacy and Aadhaar. The meetings normally last for 2 hours, 1.5 hours. That meeting went on for 3 hours and 35 minutes.
And you tweeted about it as well.
No. I don't be naughty. I only tweeted that the meeting lasts for 3.5 hours.
That's what. Yeah.
But I did not talk about the content. But interestingly, on Wednesday, boom. See, and Mamtadi has a way. We may have a 3.5 hour meeting or we'll write some note. But she has this gift or this intuition of making something sound so simple. You know, I remember when I went home that day and the lady who cooks at home, she had obviously seen this on live on a Bengali channel. She was so excited. Janin dada, didi boleche, amake ta Aadhaar card ekhon. You know, because otherwise what was her problem? She had a genuine problem. She had registered the Aadhaar somewhere in where she lived. Now, when she came to open the bank account which we wanted to open for her, she had a problem. And there are some more serious issues about Aadhaar. Here's one fact, because there's a young audience here, I don't want to give you too many stats. You know, let's say if 100 people today do not have an Aadhaar card, let's say the number is 100. Here's the startling statistic. 70 of those 100 are children below the age of 5.
And a child had to die out of hunger because her Aadhaar or whatever, you know, was not, ration card was not linked with Aadhaar.
Yeah, but death, even when demonetization took place and there was all the shouting and screaming in parliament, I remember, we stood up, Trinamool stood up, other opposition parties joined, my colleague Chukendu Shekhar Roy, the chief of the party, screaming and saying, sir, all we want is 1 minute silence for the 126 deaths. No? So it's, you know, I think, what is this? This is hubris. Oh, hubris is extreme confidence before the...
So, you know, talking about Bengal politics, not so long ago, you were under Delhi-based media criticism. Because since we are discussing social justice, I don't think we can complete the conversation on social justice without talking about the communal harmony, because that affects the population at large. And they were not happy with the fact that you had taken a decision, or your government in the state had taken a decision to, you know, have Durga Puja or Durga idol immersion, you know, sort of postponed by a day, so that it doesn't clash with the Muharram procession. Do you think it was the right decision, or do you think you could have done something different looking back?
Well, looking back, it is just beautiful. It can only happen in Calcutta. If you say Calcutta, you're fine. If you say Kolkata, you're fine. No one's going to stone your car because you said Calcutta or Kolkata. This is very cool. Red Road, our iconic Red Road. You have the Muharram prayers in the morning. A few days later, on that same Red Road, you have the Durga procession going for the immersion. Where will we get this anywhere in the world? When you had the famous classical musician, who is that? Help me, I'm getting old. Ghulam Ali. Right? When his concert got cancelled somewhere.
Oh, Ghulam Ali.
Ghulam Ali concert. Yeah. Couldn't happen in Bombay. Mm. Mumbai. Where did they come to have it? They came to have it in Calcutta. Mm. India-Pakistan match. Where did they have it? They have it in Calcutta. See, in Calcutta, there and in Bengal, there is this feel. And listen, this is a state which has seen the worst kind of... I remember my great-grandmother telling me, she was a doctor, about the great killings in the 1948. I know when I was about 7 or 8, but I still have a little memory. I wasn't 7 or 8, at 48. I'm saying when she told me the story, so don't get my age wrong. But, you know, so Calcutta has this. You know, we have this spirit. Yesterday, if you went to see the Chhat Puja on the ghat, it was wonderful. There were foreigners there. There was, you know, there was everyone there. So this certificate of, you know, communalism, this. But I think Bengal is alert. And since you asked me about Bengal politics, it is. Eventually, people know. Because at one end, when you talk about development, just look at the development which has happened. Development has happened. Social issues have been addressed. In all this, there has been communal peace and harmony. You know? I'll give you one little example, because when you talk about these big words, you know, development and, you know, this thing, give you a little, one example. When Mamata Di first came into power, came in as elected chief minister, one of the things which they came up with as a problem is that children were not going to school. Why? The number one reason for not going to school was the average time of reaching school was about 40 minutes. So that was identified as the problem. Then huddle, chief minister, solution. What is the problem? How to reduce 40 minutes to less than 10 minutes? How do you do it? So simple idea. The cycle. And that's how the Shobhu Shati cycle was created. So these are the simple ideas for people like us who live in Calcutta, come to these shows. But if you, when we go to the districts, you can actually see. I can encompass all this in two words. Touching lives. Mamata Di and the government of Bengal have touched lives.
So why do you think, I mean, what is your fight with the Delhi-based media that the same decision was taken by Nitish Kumar government? They also, you know, divided the, or sort of gave a gap, you know, postponed the Durga Idol's immersion by a day so that, you know, it doesn't clash with the Muharram. But the entire attention was focused on Mamata Banerjee's government and not Nitish Kumar.
See, Rifat, I'll tell you something. If you had asked me this question 10 years ago or 15 years ago, when I joined Trinamool, I'd get very upset and, you know, oh. Now we just look in from here, out from the other. We don't bother, you know. We don't bother. They'll do one big story on Beti Bachao, Beti Padao. Now, Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, annual budget for the entire country, all 29 states. I'm not asking quiz questions, but I'm trying to ask you, do you know what the budget is? I won't do that. The annual budget is about 150 crores. Bengal, one program called Konyashri, 5,000 crores in the last 5 years, changing lives. 5,000 crores. That's why it won the United Nations Award. What does it do? It delays the marriageable age. It's a very simple idea. So when you look at these things, eventually what happens? The Congress made an unlikely ally with the left. And everyone got excited. The brothers who run a famous newspaper down a lane in central Calcutta, they got so excited they thought the result also was over. The brothers, yes. Yeah. But what happened? And Trinamool, I'll tell you internally, we had one number in mind. I'll tell you that internally. I've never said this before, but we did have one number in mind. I don't know what number Mamata Di had in mind, because I didn't have access to her mind. Our number was very clear. Whatever we had in the assembly when we fought in alliance with the Congress in 2011, we should get one more seat at least more than that. Or exit. 185. We ended up with 211. But I suppose this is not important in the conversation. I think what is really important in the conversation is Mamata Banerjee today has delivered in Bengal, The people have trusted her in Bengal, and now she has the job at hand. People believe if there's one opposition leader who has the appeal, the conviction, the track record of governance to remove Modi, that's Mamata Banerjee.
Are you in effect saying that she is the next prime ministerial
candidate? Not at all. Not at all. Let me tell you. In a zoo or in a park, you have all kinds of creatures. Trinamool, we don't mind being the squirrel. Chota squirrel. We'll pick up the leaves. We'll nibble on the bark. But we'll have an important role to play.
Coming back to the media, a media Rifat. House in Chorangil.
How many more
about.
Questions do you have?
Just a couple more.
You're like,
well, you have, like, that was important.
Actually, I thought I would keep all my answers for this book which I'm launching in the third week of November. That's why I haven't, anyway, but chalo.
Let me try and extract as much answer from you as possible. So,
no,
you know,
I'm enjoying it.
The media house you mentioned.
You guys want to ask me something?
We will open the floor. So, I'll just ask two more. So, the media house you mentioned, have you forgiven them? Because I think that you have made peace now. Or they have made peace, or I don't know.
I haven't mentioned any media house.
Well, the media house, we know which media house you're talking about. Now they're getting ads.
Listen. This is one of the things I've learned a lot of things from my leader. Sometimes it's difficult to undertake all the things she asks, you know, her. But one of the things you learn, especially as the hair gets even silver, is that you move on. Because when you're comfortable inside your own skin, then you don't let other little things bother you. You've been there. You've done that. You've won 211 seats. When you walk into parliament with 47 MPs, they look at you differently. They listen to you because you're Mamata Banerjee's Trinamool Congress. So you get calm and you move on. So I think life is all about being positive, not holding grudges. Yes, somebody made some mistake somewhere. You know, somebody will learn. I think we all make mistakes. So it's no big deal. Yeah.
That's beautiful.
You know, it's... At one level, you have to be at a very philosophical level. Sorry, I know politicians don't. But, you know, you can be at peace with yourself. And life is not so... You don't have to be so nasty and so, you know, devious. And
it's a very refreshing thing to hear from a politician to talk about, you know, not holding grudges at a time when we are being victimized, you know, for asking questions or holding politicians to account. So thank you very much. Now, I'll open the floor for questions if anybody has any questions for Derek.
Wonderful. Nobody has any questions, so Rifat can ask two more.
Anybody any questions? Because I was going to ask some questions. If somebody doesn't ask,
No,
one more question, then let me ask.
Ali, you can ask me.
What is this alliance that's building up? You know, the Congress, yourself, various other parties. How do you reconcile AAP and Congress? I know you're very actively doing that. How do you reconcile that? By AAP, I mean Aam Aadmi Party. Yeah.
No. You see, different political parties, we have to respect their different ideologies in their space. Okay. So at one level, you have that. But there can be the national level, which can be different. We, the Trinamool Congress, when we do flow coordination in the parliament, and we do it, no secret. We are comfortable doing a flow coordination with AAP. We are comfortable doing a flow coordination with Congress. So there's not a problem there. And I think this is where you need somebody with the gravitas to pull this off. You know, how do you get the SP and the BSP to work together? Now, if a Mamata Banerjee reaches out to the SP and the BSP to work together, she has a far better chance of getting the SP and the BSP to work together. Because, see, if I try and become a tennis coach and Roger Federer tries to become a tennis coach, Roger Federer has that gravitas, he has that credibility in the tennis world. So I think Mamata ji is now at the top of her game.
But will she go for it?
What is go for it?
I mean, look, I mean, she is a successful chief minister, doing the second term with immense margin.
Mamata ji, you see the history, you see, Rifat, I think for people, most often, they judge Mamata Banerjee on what she said yesterday, day before, a track record of development and all very good. Mamata Banerjee is actually a product, I won't use the word product, she is a fruition of movements, of struggle. Today it's all very easy for me to come and sit here in a hotel and talk to you. Do you know what she has gone through? Not 1 kilometer away from here, not 1 kilometer away from here, Hazra. They almost killed her in Hazra. I've seen those pictures of those, you know, brutally beaten. She was caught literally by the scruff of her neck and her hair and pulled at Shingud. Not very long ago, 2006. What happened to her in Lal Bazar? Right. 26 days standing in the middle of Calcutta winter in December for a 26-day hunger strike. This is a woman who is not born with a silver spoon. You remember even in 1998 when she had to leave the Congress. That's a very interesting part of history. If you read modern history, you see why did she have to leave the Congress? So from that position of struggle, you know, and uprooting a regime of 34 years, people now are listening to her. But the struggle has been won for 3 decades. We have a very easy job now compared to, you know,
I think there will be.
So that means, that does not mean because she's done all that, she's going to put up her hand and say, hello, I want to be Prime Minister of India. I could see mein kuch nahi hai.
No, but you
want but to she will do what it takes to unite remove the BJP. Remove the BJP. So I hope I've given you a headline.
I think there will be a lot of takers. But the thing is, you know, because she's already done the central, she's gone back to this. In the given atmosphere of uncertainty, you know, and lack of unity in opposition, do you think she will be keen to take up that challenge?
Rifat, I have to disagree with you when you say lack of unity in opposition. No. This is not entirely true. There is a lot of unity in opposition. Otherwise, you cannot get 18 political parties to agree to do something on the 8th. And it was beautifully done. And since you mentioned this question about federalism, I want to get, what did we do? Every party could interpret Black Day in their own way. So it wasn't one central high command saying, all 18 parties. Everyone is interpreting it in a different way. I'll tell you, my friends in Chennai, I was talking to the DMK, they have a problem because they cannot do these rallies there. So they are thinking of doing it in other ways. We are doing it, Trinamool is doing it 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock, 2 to 3 p.m. all across our units, not only in Bengal, but in the 4 other states. We may do something on the social media, which is coordinated by all the opposition parties. I'm dying to tell you what it is, but I will keep quiet because we still have a few days to go. So there is a lot of opposition unity. Unity does not mean you give up your own identity. Trinamool is Trinamool, Congress is Congress, DMK is DMK. Last question, chalo. Iske baad humko chodo.
No, I mean, thank you very much. You know, I was going to ask about Mukul Roy, if you said, do you miss him? Come on, you can say that. That's it?
Sorry?
I said, do you miss Mukul Roy?
I don't think it's fair that I make any comment on an ex-colleague who is now very lonely.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, for being here and patient for all throughout the day.